Children, so today we are going to start a new topic, that is defect of vision. Defect of vision will be there when a person cannot see either the nearby objects clearly or the far objects, or both of them. Okay, this defect will occur when the image is not forming on retina. Okay, so in defect of vision, what happens? Image is not formed on retina and the person is not able to see the objects clearly. Now, there are three types of defect: myopia, hypermetropia and presbyopia. Today we are going to discuss about myopia. That is the first defect. Myopia, or this defect is also known as short-sightedness or near-sightedness. In myopia, the person is not able to see the far objects clearly. Okay? So in myopia, in case of myopia, the person can see the nearby objects clearly, but the person is not able to see the far objects clearly. Okay? Now, what is the cause of myopia? There are basically two causes of myopia. First cause is the elongation in the size of eyeball. Okay? If the size of eyeball is increased, then what will happen? Then the image will not form on retina, and we will say that the myopia will. Now, the second cause is that focal length of the eye lens decreases, or the eye lens becomes thick. Okay, so these are the two causes of myopia. Now we will understand what will happen in myopia by the red eye lens. So what you have to do, this is your eyes. Now this will be the eyelids. You have to go like this. And this is the principal axis. And here we have a retina. Now the person can see the near object clearly. So if the object is at this point, near point, then what will happen? Then the image will be formed on retina and the person will be able to see clearly. Now, so we will take this line from infinity. Okay, and for a normal person, he will be able to see that far object. So for a normal person, the image will be formed on retina and he will be able to see. Now for a myopic eye, suppose you have to draw the diagram for the myopic eye. So what will happen? Here the object is far. So the rays are coming parallel to the principal axis, and after refraction through this eye lens, the image will be formed before retina. Okay, so in case of myopia, the person is not able to see the far object because the image will be formed before retina. Now if we want to do the correction, then what will we have to do? We have to just diverge these rays so that the image will be formed at retina. So here we have to use a diverging lens because we have to diverge these rays so that the image will be formed at retina. So now the diagram for the correction, which is the most important diagram. So how will you draw the diagram for correction? And one more thing better, you have to remember that in case of myopia, the person is able to see the near object. Okay, so there will be no effect on the near point of the person. So for a myopic person, the near point is still 25 centimeter, but the far point will change. Okay, you know that for a normal person, the far point is infinite, but also. So what will we do? We will use the concave lens here. We will use the diverging lens. Okay, the object is at infinity, so the rays will come parallel. Now, when the rays will fall on this concave lens, then this concave lens will diverge. Okay, now it will diverge, and this ray again will diverge. Yes.